Jenna. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be taking down my holiday decor, and with that blank slate, I'm going to be doing a ton of restyling my home. Now, I can't even remember how my home looked before, so it's going to be really fun to just kind of have, you know, a fresh space to kind of restyle everything. I'm going to give you guys some of my favorite tips and tricks for decorating on a budget, and just little things, hopefully, that, you know, maybe if your space is looking a little bare after your holiday takedown, that you can kind of get something out of it and maybe get some fun ideas from this video. So today we're going to be concentrating on the main living area, the dining nook area, the living room, and the kitchen. I try really hard to make everything very budget friendly and, you know, shop at places where I really get the best bang for my buck. So I'm excited to share with you guys a lot of my ideas. It is sad to see the holiday stuff go, but mine has been up since October. Thank you, YouTube. So it's time to take it down and, you know, just start fresh. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so I first decided to tackle the tree corners since this is always the hardest to do. I feel like when a big, gorgeous, twinkling statement tree comes down, it always just feels a bit empty at first, but I really wanted to make this corner feel cozy, simple, and functional. So here I just stored all my ornaments in clear plastic bags so everything is really easy and simple to find next year. It's a lot easier than rummaging through boxes and wondering what is what. I love just being able to see everything, and as well as just adding a simple label, I feel like that's really gonna help out the future Jenna next year when I'm just trying to go through all my Christmas boxes and see what is what. So this is a really decent sized corner over here, and I really just love having a functional side table with a larger surface area to hold, you know, decor, coasters, a book I'm reading, or a plate of food, or, you know, whatever. So I absolutely love this side table. It's from Target and it's only $100, and I actually feel like it really closely resembles the lines in the wood from the Albert side table at McGee & Co., which is over 10 times the price of the Target one at $1,215. So a really great side table that still keeps things feeling nice and light, but has a larger surface area. So something I like to do to save money is find some really pretty coffee table books at thrift stores. And I usually look for neutral bindings and books about subjects that resonate with me. And when looking at thrift stores, I always take the book jackets off to see what the color is of the binding underneath. And I also look for really large books so I'm able to use them as statement pieces. So here I'm just going to use these two books as kind of a riser. And I love doing this because it's a great way to add some height and visual interest to place underneath a lamp or a planter. So here I just got this planter from At Home, and I bought it about a year ago. I love that it looks like a true aged antique piece, but it was only $45, and true antique black statement pots like this can go for over $200. So I like saving money where I can. So when filling a large pot with stems, I just like to pop a smaller jar or a vase inside to help add some structure to the arrangement, and it saves me from having to use a lot of stems to fill up the entire mouth of the pot. So you could just try to fill this whole vase up with stems, but it's totally not necessary with this trick, and it definitely helps save on the cost of florals and greenery. You don't have to buy as many, so that's really nice. And I did get these faux olive stems for $4 each at Hobby Lobby. They are one of the best priced olive stems around for the quality that you get, in my opinion. So far I'm loving the simplistic decor on this side table. One thing that I think really elevates any room is layering in your lighting. So I found this really cute 1920s antique desk lamp at a local antique shop, and I love how it pulls in those green tones from our olive stems, and the rusty color coordinates with the cognac colored accent pillows that I have on the sofa. It's such a cute, unique piece that really adds character to the space, but also doubles as functional lighting when I'm reading a book at night or working, so it's really nice to just have a compact little lamp that I can use. And to add to the coziness and practicality of the space, I'm layering in some of my warm winter blankets. I love this one. It's from Target. I gave several as Christmas gifts this year, and it's actually a dupe for the Pottery Barn faux fur throw. It comes in several different colors, and it adds so much texture without being overwhelming. So next, I'm going to continue layering lighting by adding this tripod floor lamp. I got this guy for 40 bucks from Ross, and I love how simple and classic it is, but it also has some unique lines with the tripod shape, and that makes it feel a little bit more designer. It also adds some much needed height to this corner now that our tall tree is gone. I love how this just finishes off the space and adds a punch of that timeless black and white contrast. I love searching for pieces that are simple and understated, but still have something unique and special about them, and I think that this lamp really does that. So next, it's time to take down the mantle decor, and this is probably the space where it feels the most empty when taken down in my home personally. I had some scuffs from the stocking holders and the garland that I just removed with a magic eraser, and I previously had a fall floral arrangement and a simple vintage dough bowl here before, but this time I want to try to add in some more styling pieces, which will definitely be a challenge since we don't have a lot of space above the mantle because of the TV, but hey, you gotta keep the husband happy, right? Mike's gotta have his big TV, so I decided it would be a good idea to try to utilize this little corner by adding some height. So I just popped these vintage brass candlesticks that I had previously used in my holiday table setup, and I think they go really great right here and add that needed height. So next, I just saved this card that I got from my grandma from a couple birthdays back. She actually hand paints them, and I thought it'd be so nice to frame this and incorporate it into some of my decor. It's really great to work in sentimental pieces into your space to give it meaning and just really make it special to you. So in addition to the card, my grandma also gave me this gorgeous woman sculpture that she made out of clay. And I feel like this really coordinates well with her painting, and the two just really play off of each other nicely. So I love that I can put it on my mantle and be reminded of her every day. Now on the other side, I thought I would gather up some neutral books that I had laying around the house and style them standing up where I had room, and then the others laying down. And I popped a mini plant on for some added interest. And I think this balances out the other side of the mantle well, while still letting some of my other statement artworks stand out and kind of speak for itself. And then next, to add some length to the middle, I just added this dough bowl that I found at Tuesday Morning. I originally had this in our guest bath as a tub tray, but I really like being able to kind of use what I have on hand in a different way so that it almost feels like you have something new. So that's it for the mantle. I feel like incorporating materials such as linen books, greenery, wood, and clay really keep this decor feeling organic, natural, and understated. So next, I kind of wanted to dress up the base of the fireplace with a couple of statement items to replace the current holiday ones that I have. So I found this really pretty olive tree at IKEA for only $50. And this guy is 53 inches tall, which makes it great for an accent piece, and I feel like it looks super realistic. I was honestly really impressed with IKEA on this one, especially for the price. This piece would look really pretty popped next to a bench in a bathroom or just an empty corner that needs a little bit of something extra. So to make it look even a bit more lifelike, I kind of just bent the tree to curve to one side, because when you look at natural olive trees, a lot of them are very bendy. So I just did this to make it a tad bit more lifelike looking. And then normally I would put this in a pot and kind of fill the empty space with moss, but I was being a bit lazy, so I just grabbed a basket that I had laying around. I got it from TJ Maxx, it was on clearance, and I just filled it out with a blanket to cover the base. Maybe I'll find a pot to put it in one of these days, but I think this looks cute for now, and I really like how the basket and blanket just add some softness to the room. And then to pop next to it, I just added this vintage stool, and on the other side, I just decided to bring back in the rustic pot and logs that I had there before. But instead of keeping the holiday greens in there, I just swapped them for some more fall-like florals to break things up, since we have a lot of greenery already going on this side of the room. So this just kind of keeps things feeling neutral and casual, and that's really it for the mantle setup. I do plan to eventually cover this fireplace in stone so it can kind of make a statement on its own with the materials, but in the meantime, it's really fun to style and break up that stark white to make it feel a bit more homey and cozy using woods, artwork, greenery, vintage pieces, and just sentimental items that really make me enjoy the decor in the space. So next, we're moving on to the kitchen, and while a statement vase and stems is pretty, I was really loving having a mini tree here over the holidays, so I decided to keep that going, and I found this really pretty rosemary tree at the Home Depot for 50% off. I think it's because it's getting too cold to plant them outside here that they were kind of clearing them out. So I thought this would be great to prune here and there and use in my cooking. And rosemary is just one of those herbs that I love the way it looks. It kind of has that rustic feel to it, which I personally really like. So I was totally planning to repot this, but I just didn't realize it was a planter within a planter. So I decided that worked, and I just stuck it in this decorative planter that I found at TJ Maxx for $15, and I'll just repot it in a couple of months when it needs it. So when it comes to coffee table, console table, or island styling, I think it always looks really good to pair a large statement vase, or in this case, a tree, with a decorative bowl. So here I have this vintage bowl that I got from an antique shop, and I decided to just add some lime bowl filler to keep things feeling light and fresh. I also think styling items in groups of three is really visually pleasing, so I also added this mini pitcher, which I actually use every day to fill my dog's water bowl, and I just love it when I can combine both design and function into my decor. So next, it was time to take down and restyle the cooktop area, and I like to keep things over here feeling very rustic with aged woods and distressed pieces. Because our kitchen is really white, I feel like this really helps warm it up and make it feel cozy. So I just swapped out my mini Christmas tree with this faux olive tree that I got from Target, and I love the distressing and the tone of the warm wood base on it and how realistic the branches look. And then next I swapped out my bells for a really cute faux vintage basket. And this really works well for transitioning into spring. And yes, I do move this if I am cooking with the back burners, but for spring I think I will put some flowers in it. But for now, I found this really kind of, you know, rustic, wildflowery looking stem at Hobby Lobby. And I like that I only need one of them, and it's a really cute touch that softens the look of this backsplash. So that's really it for the kitchen, and I love how just by layering in a couple of rustic elements, it really gives this space a cozy look that will take me through the rest of winter, but will still be a great foundation to play off of when it comes time to decorate for the spring. So next, it's time to spruce up the dining nook, and I absolutely loved this holiday table setup, but I'm not going to lie, it was not very practical. I really missed having my Lazy Susan right there with my salt and pepper shakers, my napkin holder, and coasters, and just being able to kind of use the whole table. So I got to bring back the Lazy Susan, and this was an awesome Home Goods find. It was $40, but it's really large, and I love the chippy, rustic look of it, and I like how the darker wood contrasts against our lighter table. So for a statement vase, I recently found this gorgeous antique wine rice jar at a local antique shop. It was marked $48, but this booth was having a sale, so when I got up to the register, it was only $36, which is a steal because I've seen similar vases on McGee & Co. for over $300, and then I found a super similar one online for over $200. So definitely got lucky with this vase find, and I love all of the aging on it and how it's a really subtle green. So because we don't have any statement lighting over our dining table, I really wanted to add a tall, twiggy statement vase. And this is actually a go-to for a lot of my favorite designers when they stage a dining table. I've seen a lot of them add a really large statement vase with super tall but simplistic stems in them. And I found these large stems at Hobby Lobby for $3 each on a sale week, and I only needed 4 of them. Just FYI, they do shed if you brush up against them a lot or are rough with them, but I do love how bendy and moldable they are, so you can bend them to get that really natural twiggy look. You could also forage some large branches or stems from outside for free too, but I do like with faux branches how you can set them up and you don't have to worry about them for months, and these are the perfect look for that winter to spring transition. And they're really simplistic and understated, which I love, and you can totally use them year round. Definitely a very versatile stem, and I love how large they are and how much space they take up, especially for the price. So I just popped my napkin holder and salt and pepper shakers on there to complete the look. The napkin holder was a Ross find for $8, and the salt and pepper shakers were from Marshall's, and I got those for $5. So I'm really loving this minimalistic approach for dining table decorating. Since dining tables are usually large, it's really nice to break up that space with something of a larger scale as well. And I like how we kept things neutral here, but added a subtle pop of an earthy green to break things up and played with more natural finishes like wood, marble, and ceramic. And then lastly, I just wanted to pop back in the living room for a second and do a little bit of a console table refresh. I took away all of the holiday decor that I had out, and I just decided to add some decorative boxes to balance out the table since I removed those moss trees. So kind of fills that empty space. And these were actually a Tuesday morning find, and I think that they're supposed to resemble those expensive bone boxes that you can get on designer websites. So to incorporate some wood into this styling moment, I wanted to add this handled wood bowl that I recently got from McGee & Co. And for being from a designer website, it was surprisingly pretty affordable. I think this guy was $30, and I love all the distressing and aging of the wood, making it feel really worn and found. And then I just took these faux stone beads that I had previously DIY'd and popped them on top of the boxes just for a finishing touch. And I decided to keep the florals the same because they pretty much go with any season. And by keeping the materials neutral, simple, and varied, it's easy to create a minimalistic console table statement that finishes out any living room or hallway.
All right, you guys, so that about wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed seeing my holiday takedown and total restyling of the living space. I hope you guys got maybe a little bit of inspiration from today's video. Let me know down below if you like videos like this. If you do, I'm considering doing a spring one. Definitely let me know in the comments down below what types of videos you guys like seeing from me. I so appreciate all of you watching. If you have made it till the end, thank you guys so, so much for all of your support. It really does mean so much to me, and I hope you guys are having fabulous Januaries so far, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.